Marinus Link is a proposed undersea and underground electricity and data interconnector between Heybridge in northwest Tasmania and Hazelwood in the Latrobe Valley, Victoria. It will enable the flow of more electricity in both directions, delivering low-cost, reliable and clean energy for customers in the national electricity market. Construction is expected to commence in 2026, and this will involve Marinus Link working within an easement corridor on a number of private properties to install the high voltage direct current and telecommunications cables underground. This video explains how Marinus Link will be built and what landholders can expect to see on their properties throughout construction. Details contained within this video are indicative only and are subject to change. Prior to building Marinus Link, we will work with all landholders to ensure you understand how your property is proposed to be used, your biosecurity expectations, and access requirements and important areas to avoid. We will work with landholders to develop individual property management plans to make sure that your land use requirements are met. We will install new or use existing vehicle access gates so that our vehicles and machinery can move along the worksite. Gates may be installed into existing fencing or installed within new temporary fencing depending on the location of the access required. New temporary fencing will be installed to separate the work area from livestock and other nominated areas on your property. At all times, we will work with you to minimise the disruption to your everyday farming activities. Marinus Link will be built in two stages, requiring two trenches. We aim to include most underground activities for both stages in stage one. This is likely to reduce the impact of construction to landholders between the stages of the project. As we start to develop the site, we will identify any underground or above ground services located in the area. At all times, existing water supplies to livestock will be maintained during construction activities. Trenching methods will be determined dependent on the location. Access tracks may need to be built using suitable materials to allow our vehicles and heavy machinery to safely travel to the work area. Excavated topsoil will be stored on site and compacted or seeded to limit erosion and dust after the topsoil is removed. Subsoil will then be removed from the trenches and will be dug to a typical depth of approximately 1.5 metres. Drainage trenches may also be dug to keep the site dry and to contain excavated materials. Once stage 1 and stage 2 trenching is complete, conduits to house the electricity and fibre optic cables will be installed and backfilled with cement-bound sand. The subsoil and topsoil will then be reinstated. In areas where we cannot use open trenching, such as waterways and roadways, we will use a technique called horizontal directional drilling. Horizontal directional drilling is a process whereby a drill is used to open an area beneath the sensitive environment, allowing a conduit to be pulled through. Land cables will be joined at concrete bays approximately 1,200 metres apart. The cable arrives to the site on large cable drums. Once joint bays are constructed and the conduits have been installed along the alignment, a winch wire will slowly pull the cable through the conduit. The joint bays will measure about 13 metres long, 2.5 metres wide, and 2.5 metres deep. The top of the joint bays will be buried using sand and excavated material at least 0.5 metres below the ground's surface. Joint bays will be located side by side or staggered along the alignment and be adjacent to boundary fences or other features where practical. Once in position, the two sections of power cables can then be joined. Specialised technicians will join the cables prior to backfilling to ensure the integrity of the cables. The project area is then reinstated to its prior condition unless the landholder has requested items such as access tracks to remain in place. We will work with landholders to install cable alignment pegs or signage to ensure the cable and joint bays are easily identified. Most farming practices can continue following the completion of construction. However, some activities may be restricted or prohibited within the easement due to safety reasons and the cable's technical requirements. Details around living with an easement on your property are included in Marinus Link's Landholder Information Pack. Construction of Stage 1 of Marinus Link is expected to take up to 5 years from project commencement to completion. Landholders will receive a construction lease payment for the entire construction and rehabilitation period, even if construction takes less time to complete on your property. In addition to the initial 5 years construction period, we will provide landholders with a further year for land rehabilitation. In the unlikely event that construction takes longer than 6 years, an additional lease will be required. We would like to thank each landholder for their cooperation throughout the development of Marinus Link.